Right, afternoon. Sort of a podcast without really being a podcast, Scott, would you say?
I don't know really what we're going to talk about, to be honest.
It's just sort
the
of
boxing keep... that's not going on.
Yeah, should we talk about that?
I'm really looking forward to that fight. That's not happening.
That's not happening for the foreseeable future, and we can't put any pin or any date on when things are going to be happening.
Nope.
Yeah, it's just nice to sort of check them out and check in with everyone, see how everyone's doing. How are you, Scott? You all right?
Yeah, it's just crazy.
Surreal, isn't it? This whole situation.
Working in it, we both obviously teaching a primary school, so
yeah,
it's all a bit, well...
Everything's up in the air, innit?
Yeah,
I mean, we don't really know what's going on.
Like, boxing is up in the air, and, like, everything's up in the air.
World, innit? You know, the everyday situations that were normal and not normal now. And,
not going to be normal for a while.
For a long, long time, yeah.
So
everything's different.
Apart from that, we're all right.
Other than that, everything's good. We're washing our hands, aren't we?
Washing our hands.
And, yeah, that's all we can do, I suppose, reading it. But, you know, everybody take care and look after yourselves.
That's amazing.
We understand why we're in this situation, don't we? It's important, you know. Health obviously comes first, so we understand where we are, and just everybody look after themselves.
So,
we got a good little interview tomorrow, haven't we? We managed to get Gavin Gwynne in, haven't we?
Tomorrow. We interviewed Gavin. He's the, you know, fighting James Tennyson for the British lightweight.
Yeah.
Title.
Was in Macadina, wasn't he, not long ago?
Yeah,
Gavin.
He fought on the Lomachenko and the card with Joe Cadena when the distance was a great fight. I was lucky to be there.
That was an achievement in itself, really, for Gavin, I would say.
Do you know
would
what?
You say, you know, take your hat off to that?
Definitely. I mean, obviously, Gavin's local. We're interviewing Gavin tomorrow, but
yeah.
I mean, when I saw he was in with Joe Cadena, I thought, oh, that's a ballsy. That's a ballsy fight to take. Is this going to go the distance? And to be honest, I was sat there watching it, and it was two American guys sat next to me. They were like, oh, God. And I was saying beforehand, you know, a good Joe Cadena was.
Yeah.
But yeah, it was a proper fight.
Yeah, he did it. No, in fairness to Gavin,
what people are saying about Joe Cadena, you know, he's going to be next world champion, you know, he's world class. And, well,
I think majority thought that Cadena was just going to blow him away, didn't I think, you know.
I was one of them.
Yeah, you know, no disrespect to Gavin, but I think that's what we were thinking as well, just because of the hype around Cadena and what's expected of him. But no, it was an awesome performance. So
you
don't mind facing it, do you? You know, let's be fair. Not missing much if I'm not in it. So that's something to look forward to tomorrow. It's nice to be able to do it, isn't it, I suppose, because we have been a little bit worried about what content to get out,
it's
haven't we?
It's difficult to put content out when there's no content to talk about.
No, there's nothing.
We're interviewing Gavin tomorrow, which will be really good. Hopefully the May card will go ahead, because I've got tickets for it as well.
Yep.
I'm going to be wearing my Gavin Gwynne t-shirt, Gavin, which I bought off online. And I've got to say...
He's trying his hardest, see, Gav. Gavin's flirting.
We're meeting with Gavin and Costa Coffee tomorrow.
Yep.
You know, maybe I'll buy my...
We bought last week, me or you?
Yeah.
We won't go too much into that, but no. Who did buy me or you?
I can't
last
remember.
Last Costa Coffee visit we had.
I think we just bought our own.
We did, did we?
So, last week, I'm a bit of an old one. Let's wait for a later day to discuss what happened.
Yeah. Some may know, we'll discuss that maybe.
It's in Swindon.
In Swindon.
Right now, all the way up there, and then come all the way home.
Yeah. But we had a coffee.
We told you together.
Without saying too much. We've had better Saturdays, haven't we? Mm. We have had better Saturdays.
So,
there we are, it's learning experience.
Gavin isn't going to let us down in Merth or Costa Coffee tomorrow. So
no.
That's going to be good, yeah.
Look forward to that one tomorrow.
His t-shirt, the t-shirts are really good. So I'm going to be wearing that, sporting my Gavin Gwynne t-shirt, you know. So that'll be really good. Hopefully the May card, because obviously Selby's fighting on there, he's fighting on there, Joe Cordina's fighting on there.
Yeah, so that is a good card.
I'm just hoping.
Jamie Cox is fighting on there.
Jamie Cox
from Swindon, yeah, that's right.
Oh, right.
Jamie Cox from Swindon, he is fighting on the card, he is, yeah.
Yeah.
So, yeah, we will look forward to that.
We're grabbing it through them Monday.
Hopefully we can. Yeah, it'd be nice.
It's a lovely Costa Coffee in Swindon, isn't it?
Shall we go?
That would have been really convenient to meet up with this box on Swindon in a Swindon Costa Coffee last Saturday. That would have been good. Maybe we can arrange that in the future.
Perhaps it can happen.
So yeah, hopefully the card will go ahead because I've got tickets and, you know, but saying that with the way he's looking, I don't think it is.
I think the worrying thing is, we can't say, there's so many fights that we were all looking forward to, we couldn't wait for, and they're just up in the air now, aren't they? We don't know if they're going to, will fights, the words have been put out at the moment, they're all postponed or rearranged. But if this pandemic that we're in now is going to keep going on and on and on, I mean, are these fights going to happen?
Don't know. I mean,
we don't know.
We would obviously Liam Williams and Andrade. And I can never say his name.
Andrade.
That's a fight I'd love to see.
Yeah, that's
Liam just deserves a world title shot.
He does. He does. And for me, I'm gonna put my prediction in straight away, and I think Liam Williams can beat him.
Oh, 100%.
I think he can definitely.
100%.
I love Liam Williams' style as a fighter. He's come forward. He's really sort of aggressive as a fighter, tenacious. You know, I think I make Liam Williams a favourite, and I think he'd be coming back as a new world champion, and
that'd be great. You know, it'd open so many doors, isn't it?
Because he's chipped away, Liam. He's chipped and chipped and chipped. You know, he had those two fights with Beefy, Liam Smith. Didn't get the results that he wanted in those, but he's chipped away. He started again. You know, he moved with Dom Ingle, which I think was a good move at the time. You know, no disrespect to Gary Lockett, because, you know, we get on really well with Gary, and we know how good he is as a trainer. But I think all parties agreed that it was the right change at the time.
Definitely.
And I think it's benefited everybody in that sense. And Liam is rightly going to get his opportunity, and I think he will take it with both hands.
And when you think, obviously, Lantis Fox went the distance with Andrade.
Yeah.
And then, obviously, Liam just obliterated him.
He just blitzed.
Four, was it?
I mean, was it four? I think it was four, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But he just blitzed, you know, he did.
He's just such an aggressive fighter, though, isn't he?
He is.
You know,
he is.
Him and Eubank would be unreal. Oh. It'd be a bloodbath.
It would. It'd be war. And this is something we know Liam wants. Liam fight anyone, when he Liam would.
You
won't
give us an interview though. Liam, give us an interview.
Lee, can we have an interview?
I know.
Please, we are pushing, really pushing.
Liking all his things on Twitter. And, you
we're
know.
Two nice guys from the valleys. We'd love to have a chat with him.
We did interview Landis Fox. He was fighting, but you know that wasn't because we don't like you, Liam.
Yeah,
we just you know trying to get content out there.
Yeah, that's all it was. But yeah, Liam would be great. Honestly, it would be really good if we could sit down 10 minutes, 2 times, just have a quick chat with you. That'd be
buy
awesome.
Buy me a new t-shirt as well if you got one, you know.
I'll buy you a new t-shirt, see. I'm definitely buying a new t-shirt.
So yeah, so that's all we got to say, really, Key.
Yeah, there's nothing else, really. I'm just trying to...
Yeah.
Oh, quickly before we go, yesterday I saw, maybe the day before, because everything's up in the air at the moment, Frank Warren put out about Carl Frampton and Herring. That's on now. It is agreed, obviously, we don't know where it's going to be confirmed. Quickly, thoughts, do you like that fight?
Yeah, I just feel like Carl's, since obviously losing to Josh Warrington, I'm just waiting around now, waiting for his next, you know, he's a world-class fighter, we know that. Just look at Santa Cruz, you know, the two wars he had with him.
Will he be a world champion again?
I don't see why not, I think so.
Yeah, I agree with him. Yeah, he's an awesome fighter, isn't he?
Yeah.
Brilliant fighter.
Carl, we'd have an interview with you as well. Yeah, I'll buy one of your t-shirts.
That's another one, Carl.
Ciaran, I'll buy one of your t-shirts.
Yeah, any Costa near you would be perfect. We'd love to catch up with you, definitely.
Even the Swindon Costa.
Yeah, we'd be doing
that. We know that one quite well, and we've been there.
We know our way there now, so we will catch up with you if we need to.
But bit of content tomorrow coming, Gavin, good interview.
Yeah, make sure you check it out, guys.
I'll be up. We'll be doing it tomorrow, so Sunday... Midday Sunday.
And just to mention as well, quickly, I'm in the middle of sort of writing a little article as well on Anthony Yard. That'll be a good read for your spare time, especially if we're going to be sort of indoors quite a lot at the moment, which a lot of us are. So it'd be great if you could have a little look at that, just check it out, have a read, and let me know what you think.
Anthony, if you've got any t-shirts, we'll buy a t-shirt.
If you can
give us an interview.
Great stuff.
Tunde.
I'd love to speak to Tunde, really, now. I'd love to speak to it. I watch your videos every morning. What's he saying always?
Think it.
Believe it.
Become it, achieve it.
Something along those lines, isn't it? But the guy just loves singing in his car every morning. It's awesome. I think we need to start getting content like that out. What do you think?
Yeah.
You're in a band.
I know, but I don't do singing, though.
You don't sing, do you?
No.
We had a bit of a staff get together today, didn't we? And we had a bit of a sing song, and our man, Ciaran Scott, wasn't part of it at all. He wasn't feeling it. Banged the table a little bit, but he didn't sing at all.
So yeah,
it's been good to catch up.
You know, when we're scraping the barrel and we've got to do songs,
we're talking about songs. Yeah. I know, yeah, we are scraping.
We'll start doing like throwback fights, you know, what people's favourite throwback fights.
I think we need to get back to that. Throwback Thursdays.
Yeah. Even just throwback.
It's gonna have to be daily. It's gonna have to be daily throwbacks, I think, isn't it? Because
just to get talking about boxing and not COVID-19, that's quite, you know, serious, but quite boring, just scrolling down Twitter.
It's everywhere at the moment, isn't it? But so, obviously, we do understand, you know, everybody keep safe, keep healthy, take all the precautions that everybody's advising, and hopefully we can, fingers crossed, get back to doing what we know, what we love, and, you know, get back to sort of being in normal day-to-day situations, I suppose, is what we want to say, innit?
Yeah.
But yeah, check our interview out tomorrow. Gav, we look forward to seeing you.
Cheers, guys.
Nice one, guys. Take care.